Welcome to the end of day two at the 2023 Women's World Floorball Championships in Singapore. You're watching Overtime, where Jörg and I discuss all of the talking points of the day. And a day, Jörg, of close results. Where to go to first? Well, why don't we go to the go-tos, Yui and Rei of Japan. Great performances by them and indeed the Japanese team, who beat the Danes. Japan beat Denmark.
It's brilliant for the sport. It still does not happen too often that a European team is losing against a non-European team. So that's really great. And Japan basically continues where they have stopped in the qualification. Now just different opponents, European teams, and they still manage to get away with victories. Brilliant work.
They got a real prospect of actually making it through to the playoff round. Of course, they still have to beat the USA, but they put themselves in a great position. 3-2 win over Denmark. Now, another close game, and let's face it, it was always likely to be a close game, was Norway and Latvia. These two nations, Jörg, have given us great entertainment for years at the WFC.
Yes, they keep battling each other somewhere, usually around 5th to 8th spot, and depends from year to year who's a little bit stronger. And yeah, it has shown. Both are pretty strong, both are very equal, and in the end, a very minor margin of one goal difference.
4-3 win to the Norwegians. The lead changed hands three times during that match. Really important contest in their quest to either make it to the quarterfinal stage outright or get preferential treatment in the playoff round. Well, Germany, not a close game here. They absolutely walloped the French. The French played with their characteristic bravery, with heart, with passion. They've been great entertainers here at these championships. But Germany are in no mood to be kind to anyone here, are they?
No, Germany definitely on a mission, we mentioned before. They want to get back into the top eight. And at the same time, France had a great game the night before. Great experience, first time. Everything first time, and now they basically switch on. Whoa, it's all new, it's amazing, it's great, which it still is, but it's kind of a start of have to confirm a performance you already have delivered on the first day. You have to bring it up a second day, but you're more tired, a possible stronger opponent. So it doesn't make it easier for them, but I'm pretty sure for them it's still great experience and a steep learning curve.
And they didn't have much time, did they? They were played in the last game, I think, last night, and then one of the earlier matches today. I mean, that's just the nature of the draw. That's how it happens in these competitions. But for the French, definitely a bringing back down to earth. Now, they'll take on even Australia next. But for the Germans, they'll meet Singapore. Remember 2019? Remember the playoff round? 7-6, that win for the Germans. One of the best games I've ever commentated. It was an extraordinary contest. Well, Singapore have just beaten the Australians. That finished a matter of minutes ago, 4-2. It was, Jörg, and I know you know a thing or two about Australian floorball, it was a classic Singapore-Australia battle. They really gave it everything. Great friendship and respect before and after, but during the match, they wanted the win.
Yeah, it's the Asian-Oceania derby over 20 years. And so, yeah, this is basically, I would say, from an Australian perspective, the game you definitely want to win, but at the same time, at least from my experience, at the same time, the most difficult one to win. And yeah, Australia today, I think a much better performance than on day one. They finally scored. They have now hopefully arrived for them at the tournament. But Singapore again in front of the home crowd, strong and good enough to bring the victory home. And once more, I always think, For the tournament as such, it's really important that the host is having a great game, is having wins, keeps the spectators coming back. And so really looking forward to that clash for Singapore.
It's going to be fascinating. Singapore are going to have to deal with Annalena Best because she's been in fantastic form so far, scored 4 goals in the win against France, one of Germany's top players. Now let's look at the three of the big four that were in action today, and starting with the Czech Republic taking on Poland. Before we go into the details of the match, an interesting story here. The World Floorball Championships tends to bring together players from all over the world, some of whom are divided by their national jerseys, but united by their clubs and by friendship. Have a look at this.
Veronika Noga and Martina Rebkova you ladies are teammates at Zug United, but today you're opponents. Firstly, Veronica, how is that for you, facing against a friend and teammate?
Yeah, in one way it's a really good challenge. Like everyone knows, she's so fast, so it's a challenge for me to catch her. And it's awesome to know so many players on the field. It's a bit different feeling, but still, here we are opponents, so everyone is fighting for their own team.
And Martina, what is it like to come up against her and maybe battle against the boards?
Yes, it's the same. She's also really fast, but mostly we play against each other, so it's quite challenging, and we know pretty well each other, so it's more difficult. But I think, as she said, I think we are opponents here, so it's really on the field we are opponents, but after the game we are again teammates. No.
And this is the second time, because for both of you, you were in qualifications earlier this year, in February in Lignano. Do you have any lingering hostilities from that day, from that match before, or is it a lot better now between you?
Yeah, it's tough to say. In general, we knew that during the qualification it was a tough game, it was quite close for us. We wanted to keep it, and of course both teams made quite big progress during this time. I think there's still small gap. Okay, I would like to be smaller, but we're going to get there, like between top four and us, and we are always trying our best. We wanted to be in the top four, so one day we're going to beat them.
And for you, Martina, what's it like playing against Poland in general? How do you feel that they're developing?
I guess the Poland, they are really growing, really. I think we know it, and many players are in abroad, so we know them. They have really high quality, and I think in the future they can be really, really in the top five. And I guess it'll be really great, I think, in general for the floorball. So I have to say it's really always really tough game for us.
And last but not least, ladies, are you still going to be friends after this match?
Hey, of course!
Hey, definitely!
Nothing to break it.
Thank you very much.
It's a great example how teamwork works, basically, on home soil, but now here during a World Championship. And in this case, there's several additional players in this team from Zug United in Switzerland. We could have taken another two Czech players, and I'm pretty sure so for the Polish captain, Veronika Noga, it was a pretty special game.
It was also an extremely good win for the Czech Republic, 9-3. On the subject of teams scoring 9 goals, Finland beating Switzerland by 9-5. This was an odd game, wasn't it?
In one way, yes. The first 40 minutes, or the first two periods, were with a very clear and dominant outfit from the and performance from the Finnish team, clearly dominating Switzerland. And to me, it looked a little bit like Switzerland. Oh, okay, last period, nothing to lose. We drag the goalie out, we throw 6-5, and suddenly goal after goal after goal coming in. Mm. Of course, in the end, 9-5 is still a very clear result in terms of floorball when these top nations are clashing. So I'm kind of wondering, what can we take out more out of it? Is it the top 40 minutes from the Finnish team? Again, second period, Kauppi twins and brilliant once more? Or is it rather than suddenly the Swiss team waking up in the third period and performing and basically getting under the skin from the Finnish team? So that will be the question over the next week, and both teams going to play again tomorrow, and in about 24 hours we will know who will be first and who will be second in this group.
The only way to find out who's going to be victorious in the group is to watch all of the action on either the IFF app or on your local broadcaster tomorrow. We've got two more days of group play at the WFC 2023, so you'll have to tune in for more action and, of course, more overtime. We'll see you soon.